I was already doing this monumental kind of installation with the paper, and it's quite a big jump from my small miniature painting to this huge mountains of crumbled papers, and doing it in front of people and involving them and making them as part of the whole installation and or performance. So there's a very interesting sound as well of the paper. When you're crumbling it, it's a very fragile kind of object, but when so many people are doing it at the same time, it's like some sound of machines or factory kind of thing. So we are using that sound in the main lobby when you entered, and then when you go up, you will explore the main source behind the whole thing. The piece is called "And They Still Seek the Traces of Blood." I will give my own experiences when there were so many bomb blasts in Pakistan or even in anywhere in the world. The common people are asked to stay away from the site. You have to rely on their given information. Here the people will be investigating at their own. They are allowed to touch the work. And this whole idea of constructing something by an act of deconstruction. I use images from my previous installation, floor paintings. I just take the photograph of that detail of some floor painting, and I got them printed on thousands of sheets of paper. So here we are using, I think, 30,000 sheets of paper to construct this installation. It looks like some kind of meat or human body part or stains of blood on the piece of cloth. But you come close to it, you will see the very finely rendered images of flowers emerging out of the blood, which is about violence and hope, or violence and beauty, or life or destruction of life. What kind of the response that I found from the people, it moved them. They started thinking about so many different things which are maybe they haven't experienced directly, but they are happening everywhere in this world.